okay, we're heading up to the gym. Today, we're going to work on our core. We're going to do some pull-ups. We're going to do some squatting. We're going to do some curling, and we're going to do some bench pressing. These are the type of workouts that's going to build overall muscle and body strength. So see you guys at the gym. Okay, we're going to start this workout with pull-ups. I like starting my workout with the pull-ups because it allows for me to warm my muscles up to prepare them for the heavier weights that I'm going to take on as I progress through my workout. I also like starting off with the pull-ups because it allows for me to work on not only my upper body, my arms, my chest, my shoulders, but it also allows for me to work on my abs and my core. Now, when you're doing a workout like this, this forces your core or your abs to work out over time. And this is going to get you that definition that you're looking for when you want to have the shape, the perfect shape abs. Next, we're going to move on to the bench press. Today, I'm starting off with 240 pounds on the bench. I usually start off with 250 pounds on the bench. However, today, knowing how much I'm going to work out, the different muscle groups that I'm going to work on, I'm implementing weight training and cardio and a whole host of different techniques and exercises in this one workout. So I have to keep that in mind. So here I'm just doing three sets of five reps with 240 pounds on a bench. Now I'm going to take it down to 225 pounds on the bench, and same thing, going to be doing three sets of five reps. And I like to start off with the heavier weights and work my way down, because if you know anything about working out and lifting heavy weights, the heavier weights allow for you to bulk up, and then the lighter weights doing more or high reps get you the definition. So I like to keep that bulk that I have, my muscle mass that I have, but I also want to also have a certain level of definition. So I start off with the heavier weights, work my way down to the lighter weights. Here you can see that now I have 185 pounds on the bench, and I'm gonna do the same thing, five reps, three sets. And like I said, high reps, lower weight is what creates definition. Heavier weights, lower sets creates the bulkiness. And here I'm curling 70 pounds. And I typically like doing my curls as you see I'm doing here. Lift the curl bar over my head and also curl with the same movement. And this allows for me to work on more muscle groups than just curling alone when I actually extend the curl bar over my head. Now I'm gonna be doing some squatting. I like squatting because squatting is gonna just build overall body strength. This is gonna work on your core. This will get you definition. This is gonna work on your legs. This is gonna work on so many muscle groups. And as you see I'm doing here, this is 135 pounds. And I usually start off with around 135 pounds. I'll either work my way slightly up or I'll either work my way down depending on how much I'm gonna do that day, depending on what my workout regimen is gonna entail. So here I've moved down from 135 to 95 pounds. And so what I typically do is I usually do 3 to 4 sets of 10 squats per set. And so I think I started off with doing 3 sets of 10 squats with 135 pounds, and now I just went down to 95 pounds, 3 sets, 10 squats. Now I'm gonna move on to my next exercise. I'm starting off with, I think, either 30 pounds or 50 pounds. And I like doing this workout because it's gonna work on my chest, it's gonna work on my arms. It also burn a lot of calories as well. Weight training is extremely good for keeping your body in a metabolic state, a state where you're gonna constantly burn calories, even when you're sitting and being in a restful state. When you have a lot of muscle mass just by how muscles are made up, you're just gonna burn calories sitting down versus having fat on you. Now, this is the part of the workout that I really, really like to get into. This always remind me of Rocky when he was doing the one-hand push-ups, jumping from one arm to the other arm. And believe it or not, this definitely works on your upper body. You have to have a certain level of balance and coordination. So this is a great workout. This is a great move to implement in your regimen, and it's definitely burn calories and will build upper body strength. We're gonna move on to my ultimate highlight of the gym, jump roping. I absolutely love jump roping. This is gonna push me to a certain level, unlike weight training. Cardio is something that I really love. I feel like it's something that keeps me in the best shape. I love doing the tricks. This is gonna burn 20 to 30% more calories as opposed to running. And when you're jump roping at this level, you're gonna burn even more. Stay strong.
Throw your punches. When you throw one punch, make sure you have your guard up like this. So if you get countered, you protect yourself. Same thing with the other hand. See that? You know? Boom. Boom, boom. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Like that, right? Three punches in 1 second. Watch this. Ba ba ba! You heard that, right? Ba ba ba! Watch this. Nah, let me stop. It's silly, for real. I'm gonna go ahead and do it this time. Bah!
Ba-da-bop.
Ba-da-bop! 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 Just like that. Ba-da-bop! Three punches, 1 second.
Ba-da-bop.
That's how fast they come. They come so fast you won't even see them.
Ba-da-bop.
You know?
Ba-da-bop.
Ba-da-bop!
Ba-da-bop.
Ba-da-bop! Hooks to the body. Ba-da-bop! Ba-da-bop!